Hi, have you used the LinkedIn events feature yet to grow, sustain your business? It's a great feature. I want to jump into this and talk to you about why you should be using LinkedIn events feature. We all have it and the benefit to you. And so here's the way I say it up front when I'm talking to people that I'm helping and working with is that you want to create as part of your sales, marketing, and branding foundational components, your TV show. This is something that you put together as a virtual event. And I say TV show because think about a TV show where you create the branding around it. There's consistency to a TV show, the same time every week, every day, every month. And there's certain messaging, content. And when you do that, people get used to your show. They expect it, you can hype it, you can market it, and having your virtual TV show with your brand, you know, your style, your fonts, your colors, and how you want to set it up is just a phenomenal tool. And it allows you to stand out, show up in different and unique ways, brand yourself, build an audience, convert, and all of that. And so once you have that process down of creating your TV show and it's branded, you get all the pieces connected together. Then you want to start thinking about your feature here on LinkedIn events. And the show, I should say, your TV show can be anything you want it to be. The only limit is the limit of your imagination when it comes to creativity. It could be just you talking, it could be you with guests. For instance, I have a weekly show that I do called Giant TV every Thursday at 1 p.m. California time, where I just want to deliver value on people who are growing, standing out, and sustaining a business. And so mine is about all of those things, you know, sales, marketing, branding, tools, strategies, and every week. And so I've seen my audience go from virtually zero when I started doing it to now it's building up to hundreds and hundreds that are showing up for my show. Now I have LinkedIn Live. You don't have to have LinkedIn Live. And as a matter of fact, I'm talking about for this tutorial here about using Zoom integrated with LinkedIn events. And so I've just seen great, you know, great things happening with my own show. And I'm constantly tinkering with the events feature here. LinkedIn's putting a lot of attention on it. They have really made a big focus on the fact that it's online now, and so they've tailored the events feature for online scenarios. It's great. So let's jump into this. Let's do a test here. And this is my LinkedIn site here. You go down your site on the window pane here. Here's the events, and you want to click on the plus sign, and this is where you come to where you design your event and put your event up there. LinkedIn allows you to customize it in a few ways. You can put a banner up here. I'm just going to do a test banner to show you how it looks. You want to make sure your banner is formatted here. And for this one, I'll just apply this. And I recommend using Canva. You know, go to Canva, find the right dimensions, create your banner for your event. You want to make this banner pop, colorful, and talk to the event. So maybe you could have language up there that describes what the event is, or you could have the same banner every time to create consistency, like a TV show, you know, intro banner, whatever it is. You could have that. Point is, have a great banner that pops. You can also customize this. I'll put in here or my giant TV logo and just pop that in there. And so, you know, you format this right, it all looks great. And so there you have those two pieces you can tailor. Now you get to the event name, hugely important. Think about an email subject line. There's a science behind an email subject line. You want to get people to open the email, you want to get people to click on your event because you're going to be inviting your connections. The first thing they're going to see is they're going to get a notification they've been invited to an event. And they're going to see the event name, and it'll say you've been invited to an event, and then the event name. And you want to customize that and really put some thought into who your audience is and what is going to make them curious to click on that and read more about your event and sign up. And example is maybe you have a great practice management tool or set of tools for dentists. And so you are going to be inviting your dentist connections, and in the subject line could be, you know, hottest new practice tools for dentists, and something like that that grabs them. You have 75 characters here, so you ought to have room to put it there, and they're going to see the first, you know, snippets of it. So put thought into the event name. I'll just do test here. And by the way, you can put emojis in here, smiley faces, you know, things you think might grab someone's attention. Emojis work well in email subject lines to stand out in email, you know, feed that we all see. So do that. Then you get to organizer here, and you can do this from a company page or your personal page. I choose my personal page because I'm really developing my personal brand always, and it just, you know, people connect more to a person, and if they can resonate with you, you're a human being versus a company logo, a page. Nothing wrong with doing the company, you know, putting the company in here for organizer, but it's sort of a specific strategy there. So you have your personal profile. Make sure this is toggled here to yes, it's an online event. New page down, broadcast link, don't need to use that. You know, if you were live streaming from a different source, maybe use that, but I don't use that. Time zone, of course, time zone. I'll just put tomorrow. And for the time frame of the event, so I have my weekly show every Thursday, 1 p.m., Giant TV, delivering value, tool strategies to grow, stand out, foundational components for your sales and marketing platform, all just trying to help people. I run that 45 minutes. That's a good time frame. I like that. I can really say a lot, but not, you know, bore people to death going 2 hours and you know, lose people. And you also don't want to do like a 5-10 minute event. You want to just make this a meat on the bones event. 45 is a good time frame. Then you get to description and spend some time here. I recommend you go Google Doc it and write your description there. It's kind of clunky to do it here. And tell a story. What's the value people are going to receive from checking out your event? And what, you know, you can tell a little bit about yourself, your bio. Don't make it me. Make it about your audience and hype it up. Now, this involves obviously copywriting here, and there's a talent to that. And, you know, there are resources for figuring out what people respond to when it comes to copywriting for events. So, you know, spend some time and do it right because this matters. And you have a lot of space here, 5,000 characters. But you know, when people click on it and you have the title, okay, they're going to read more. You want them to read something that is attracting them. Stories, emotions, solutions, all about them. Speakers, if you had a speaker on LinkedIn, you were including connection, you could tag there. I haven't used that feature. Ticketing website. Okay. We're doing a Zoom here, right? So you have your TV show. You're doing it weekly, monthly, quarterly. Set time. You're providing value. And now you have your Zoom set up and you're going to be broadcasting that. The ticketing website, I don't recommend having the Zoom link on there. You could. People click on it and they sign up right there. But Zoom doesn't have a landing page that looks great. It's just a crappy Zoom landing page. And what you can do is use Eventbrite, and you know, it's a service most of us know. I think mostly it's free, and you go there and create your landing page. You can have some more photos on there, and then you have the Zoom link on Eventbrite, and so you direct people there. You're continuing to hype, sell them, keep them motivated, and then they click on there and they sign up for your Zoom. What you're also doing is you're collecting name and email address, which is golden. Email should be treated like a piece of gold because then you can take that and you can get that onto your email nurture campaign where you are continuing to build rapport, credibility as you touch base with them going forward. And by the way, you can automate that where people sign up. You can automate getting that email onto your email nurture list. And hopefully what you're sending out to email nurture is a video, short snack size video providing value, and that's your vlog. and you're sending that out as your email nurture campaign. You're automating that whole thing. Another discussion about that, but this is what you do. So Eventbrite is your ticketing site. People sign up, you're collecting email. It's awesome. Make it public. And then I've got to put in a description here so it'll take it test. Okay. So now I have that. Okay. This is the default that pops up. This is what LinkedIn creates, and you can publish this, share this in your newsfeed. And you can delete this here, you know, and put something better there and write something. You could really take a snippet of your summary or maybe your whole summary from the event, copy and paste it in here, and put appropriate hashtags at the bottom. And you can see what it pulls here. The reason this is kind of beneficial is because you probably know LinkedIn hates external links, whether you're throwing a YouTube link in there, a landing site link, a link to an article. LinkedIn doesn't like it. The algorithm doesn't like it. It just mutes the sharing of your content if you have external links. So when you use this here, then this stays within the LinkedIn ecosystem. There is no external link. It's right there. And you just have a better opportunity of reaching more people when you do it this way. So I'll X out of this. I'm doing a test event. So there's the event. So this shows up. And what you now need to do is you got to invite people to the event. So you can invite first level connections as opposed to second and third level connections. You can invite first level connections, which is why it's so important to build up a large first level connection base in LinkedIn of people that are good connections for you. The bigger the better. Because when you have a lot of first level connections, great things happen. You can direct message these people. You can also invite them to your events. You can see their content. You can start engaging at a higher level. And you just make a lot of noise. When you have a big crowd around you, you know, not that every single person you're connected to is an ideal prospect, but you got a lot of noise around you. And that's always a good thing. So that's a discussion in and of itself. But here, you want to click on Invite Connections. Okay, this is pretty cool. LinkedIn allows you to search industry, schools, companies, geo. So let's say industries, I'll just do, you know, accounting. See, you know, apply. These are my first level connections. So now everyone in accounting I'm connected to comes up here, a lot of CPAs and so forth. And if I'm doing an event specifically for accountants and CPAs, this is fantastic. I'll do this. And then you can invite all these people. And there is no cap that I've been able to discover on the amount of people you can invite. Hundreds and thousands. I'm inviting a ton every time. And so you do this and you just, you know, click, boom, and invite. And they will get a notification in their notification tab that they were invited to the event. Now remember, it'll say you're invited to an event and it will show the subject line, which is why your subject line's got to be tight. So this is great. You can search around and just have at it and invite away. And again, first level connections only. Now, once people start accepting, you'll start to see the attendee list here. You'll see the people, the number. And obviously not that everybody will show up. It's like any event. You may get, you know, I don't know, 40 people that sign up and 10 show up. You know, it's just the way it is. And you got to get people used to your events and start building that audience. But you will see them here. And that's great because you can see what's going on. And then here's something else I want to mention is in the events have its own news feed there. You're looking at it and you can start conversations in here, and it's specifically within the context of this event. And what I typically do, and as I'm getting more and more into this and starting to see some real benefit from it, I do LinkedIn Lives. You don't have to have LinkedIn Live, but, and we're talking about a Zoom event here we're doing, we're integrating with, but But Live is great for this too. This integrates with LinkedIn Live. But you start a conversation in here. What I typically do is I'll wait for people, attendees, to start showing up, and then I'll start hyping the event. I'll go to my mobile phone. I'll find the event on my mobile phone, on my profile. You can do that. Pull up the event, and I'll record a video right into the event, and I'll hype it. And I'll tell them what's great that's coming up. I'm excited about it. You know, what they have to look forward to. And here's a really killer thing about the event feature. It's amazing because not many people know this even exists. But when you post that hype video, for example, in the event, now you can recommend that post to to people, to your attendees. And what LinkedIn will do is they will push out a notification, which will show up in your attendees notification tab up here. They will push out a notification that you just published a piece of content. So they get notified. LinkedIn doesn't do that in other places on the platform. They don't notify people. They don't push out notifications. They do in events. And you can do that up to 3 times, 7 days apart when you put on an event. It's pretty insane. And it's a way to proactively notify folks that they signed up for it, get ready, it's coming. In addition to that, LinkedIn notifies all the attendees 7 days ahead of time, 3 days ahead of time, and the day of the event. So you got those just automatically going out by LinkedIn, which is, again, showing up in the notifications tab. And what you can also do is you can provide documents in the newsfeed of the event. Maybe you want people to follow along to something and put the PDF in there, you know, those sort of things, and push that out to your network so you can really kind of get things going in the newsfeed of the event. Okay, so let me make sure I'm not missing anything here. You want to make sure to mention to your attendees that they can invite their own first level connections. They can share the event. So now you can piggyback on that and, you know, get more people to show up because you're motivating your attendees to invite their connections. Okay, so now you have this, and now you're doing the Zoom. So you got your Zoom set up. People are going, putting their name, email on Eventbrite. You're collecting that, getting that into email nurture. You're doing the Zoom. Now you're recording the Zoom every time. So you record it because then you can repurpose that piece of content. Grab the Zoom recording, edit it, brand it for your TV show. It goes up in YouTube, your YouTube library, where you have your videos. You're, you know, repurposing it on LinkedIn. Maybe you cut a snippet out of there, and then a link in the comment section when you post the snippet video, a link to the full video on YouTube. You know, it's a way to get around the link, negative link thing on LinkedIn. And you can repurpose it, the video, put it up on, maybe you have a Facebook company page and maybe you have a LinkedIn group, and who knows what, all your channels can get out there. And then you can also repurpose it into your email vlog. You're sending out, you're nurturing your people, and you could send this piece of content out that way to show the value provided. They're just repurposing a piece of content like this, epic. So now you have this event. So, and if you're scheduling this, like we said, your TV show, you're marketing this beforehand. So you set up your event. How do you market an event? Well, you have an email list, you know, so you can market email list. Hey, I'm putting on a great LinkedIn event. Go over here, connect with me, watch my event, sign up. You know, you can just do it in your regular LinkedIn newsfeed. You know, you can, you know, manually hit some hot prospects. Hey, I'm having this great event. Would love for you to check it out. Invite a team, invite a company, again, limitless on what you can do for these events. But if you do them consistent, you will see your audience build, people get used to you, you'll get noticed, and you'll have engagement with people as you go along. So one other thing I want to mention, because it's very interesting, if I go to an old event that I did that's already passed, so let me go. I go to my events, pull one up here. Okay, let's go this one. I did an event, on leveraging virtual events. And I did an event on this, and I had, you know, over 100 people show up, 174, one of my earlier events, great, getting good numbers. So now these people are still in here. What I can go and do in here, which I've kind of experimenting with, it's pretty unreal, is I can post in an old event, and then I can recommend or notify attendees of my posts. And what I can do is I can post in there about my new event coming up. These people are interested. They signed up. Now I can say, hey, I have this other great event. Love to have you there. Go check it out. And I've got, you know, these 174 people that are now going to get a push notification about my new event. Insane, you know, and I haven't seen these events drop off. LinkedIn's not deleting these automatically. So I don't, you know, we'll see. We'll see if these live in you know, forever. But I'm being very strategic about this. And so in conclusion here, my summary is, as part of your sales, marketing, branding foundation, include a virtual event. Create your TV show. Incorporate Zoom and LinkedIn events and use this tool. Be consistent. Build an audience. It's a great component to add to the other pieces as you're doing your thing and moving forward. So hope you got some value from it. Thanks. Continue to follow me. I'll keep putting out content like this, and always love to learn about anybody's business. So thanks so much.
I'll be the bad guy now.